Fraternal correction and community prayer are two very important aspects of Christian life. There is a story about a young altar boy. One day, while he was serving at the mass, he accidentally dropped the glass cruets containing water and the wine on the marble floor in the sanctuary. The priest yelled at him and told him, "Get out of here and don't come back." That boy never went to church again. He went on to become the communist leader of Yugoslavia, Marshal Tito. There was another young altar boy who also accidentally dropped the cruets at the altar. These cruets broke into pieces, but this time the understanding and patient priest patted the young fellow on the back and said, "Don't worry about it, son. Be careful next time. You will probably be a bishop someday." This altar boy grew up to become Archbishop Fulton J. Sheen, an ardent proclaimer of God's word, who is now on the path to sainthood. Fraternal correction with love is the duty of every Christian. Progress in Christian life is made by correcting the mistakes. Patience is the key. We do not get the chicken from the egg by crushing it, but we get the chicken from the egg by patiently hatching it. In the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 18, verses 15 and 16, Jesus said, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother." The responsibility of calling a person to repentance falls on the community. In Jesus' time, people lived in small and closely knit communities and not in mega cities like we have today. Thus, the idea of fraternal or communal correction was quite familiar to them. In the early Christian communities, fraternal correction was crucial because it helped solve internal disputes and ensured harmony of a common life for all. So if a brother or sister strays, it is the duty of the whole community to restore him or her to the community life. In fact, we are called to be our brothers or sisters' keeper. St. Paul, writing to the Romans, chapter 13, verse 8, reminds us of being faithful in loving one another. He said, "Owe nothing to anyone except to love one another, for the one who loves another has fulfilled the law, and love does no evil to the neighbor." Just as God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, he is also entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. In the book of Ezekiel, chapter 33, verses 7 to 9, we find that the prophet was called to become God's mouthpiece to fraternally correct the people of Israel and lead them to repentance. "Thus says the Lord, you son of man, I have appointed you watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me." Like a sentinel, Ezekiel sounds a warning. He blows a whistle to awaken our conscience. He questions the status quo. He challenges the system. He calls us individually to remove the obstacles and barriers that stand in the way of God's plan for us. Jesus also tells us to fraternally remind again and again those who go astray. He says, "If he does not listen, take one or two others with you, so that every fact may be established by the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. And if he refuses to listen even to the church, then only treat him as a Gentile." Apart from fraternal correction, another very important way to grow in our Christian life is community prayer. Many years ago, in a small parish community where I served, it so happened that one little child was diagnosed with blood cancer. The young parents were upset and they asked for prayers from the parish community. The response of the community was very positive. The parishioners organized themselves into small groups and began prayer meetings together. They met together for prayers in the child's home, in the parish church, and in their own homes for the complete recovery of the child. All of them fell with the young family and cried out together to the Lord. Jesus could not but listen to their prayers. The child was cured completely. Jesus said, Amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. The prayer of a community united in love is more powerful than individual prayers. For where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them. Listening to the words of Jesus, let us also help one another to grow in Christian life by our acts of fraternal correction and community prayer. Let us proclaim with the psalmist, "Oh, that today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts."